Hi guys, Jeremy here from Environmentarian.
James Isaacs, I'm a licensed builder. We've been building with hemp for about 15 years. Provides a very well insulated home in cooler climates in winter and warmer climates in summer. This building has been designed completely off-grid. We've done quite a lot with Dick Clark from Envirotecture.
Hi guys, Jeremy here from Environmentarian. I'm here with James Isaac, a professional hemp home builder, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the property.
James Isaacs, I'm a licensed builder, and I'm also director of my own company, Belubula Hemp Homes. We're based in Hartley Vale, just over the Blue Mountains. Been here about 7 years now. We service a fairly large piece of Australia, wherever we need to go, basically. There seems to be work all over Australia with hemp now, and a lot of people showing a lot of interest, so we're quite happy to travel and advise. We've been building with hemp for about 15 years. We started, first place was a little town out the other side of Orange, and that came about with a lady that had it was her grandfather's farmhouse, and she wanted to build something similar to the farmhouse, so she decided to use hemp.
So just a quick shout out to our primary sponsor, the Hemp Building Directory, where you can find out all things hemp building, from architects and designers through to suppliers of hemp building materials and builders and installers. Head to hempbuilding.au for more info.
And approached me. I looked into it further and it ticked a lot of boxes with sustainability, a lot of carbon benefits as well. Plus it provides a very well insulated home in cooler climates in winter and warmer climates in summer. So there was a lot of benefits, and from there I've just carried on pretty much building with hemp ever since. This building has been designed completely off-grid. We don't have town water and sewer and electricity facilities here. We were too far away to connect into the grid, so it wasn't actually a choice to go off-grid, but in hindsight, it's worked out as probably one of the better things that we've done. We don't get any bills for utilities whatsoever. It's really good. Our solar system was a fraction of the cost of hooking up to the grid. We run a gravity-fed water system from up on the hill there. All our electricity is generated here. We've got two electric vehicles that we charge. The whole thing sort of works together very well, with leaving a very minimal footprint for carbon. The building itself was a big carbon sequester, and we've tried to minimise our carbon footprint with everything else. Most of our buildings are designed with aspect as one of the main concerns for people. A lot of buildings these days are built in the complete wrong direction to make the most of the sun and winter and summer. Most of the buildings we've built have all had reasonable size eaves and well insulated windows. It's all part of the passive solar design. This place, for instance, had to be designed faced with a roof facing north for our off-grid solar system. So there's a lot of things to take into account when thinking about building a new house, and I think aspect is one of the most important. We've done quite a lot with Dick Clark from Envirotecture. He's very good with the hemp designs, which can be sometimes a little different to a lot of standard designs. All the work I've done has been in situ, so cast-in-situ walls, which consists of a structural timber frame with standard type roofing, etc. on top. There's no rocket science involved in that. We found the best way to insulate the houses and to get the most benefit out of the hemp is to cast-in-situ. I've built around 15 to 20 hemp homes. Not all of them have been my buildings, quite a few of them we've just done the hemp component for other builders and clients, and that's over about a 10 or 15 year period. If anyone would like to know more about hemp building with cast in situ, we're located in Hartley Vale. If anyone does a search through Google, we're quite easy to find, and yeah, happy to help out wherever we can.
If you're interested in being a sponsor of the Hemp Building podcast or a Hempcrete in Australia YouTube video, please reach out to me at jeremy@environmentarian.au. Hope to hear from you soon.
My name's Michelle Isaacs and I'm the director of the Hartley Vale Good Garlic Company. And the Hartley Vale Good Garlic Company specialises in organically grown garlic, and we use sustainable and regenerative agricultural methods in order to grow our good garlic. What's also important to our business is being able to store the garlic in a building that's able to control humidity really well, which is what Hempcrete is absolutely perfect for. So that's what we do, and there's a lot of people who love our Australian grown garlic. They're lovely big cloves, but they're organically grown.
So she's gathered all these frames from Vinnie's and wherever else, the Cat Society, and and we sort of rendered around so that you could still see bits of the hemp. When we did our hemp, we had the bushfires on top of us and a lot of the frame was exposed, so we just really had to get the hemp in quickly, and we rushed it with all sorts of people that turned up to help, and a lot of it was pretty rough. So that was why we went for the render on the inside.
So just a quick shout out to our primary sponsor, the Hemp Building Directory. You can find out all things hemp building, from architects and designers through to suppliers of hemp building materials and builders and installers. Head to hempbuilding.au for more info.